Okay, so we can translate expression by exploiting its structure. Okay, so some here the exploiting is nothing but what can I say? By evaluating, okay, the structure is like this. If you have this, and if you know what this can lead you, what value it can evaluate and give you, and what value this can give you, then you can just translate. This is what we call translation. Okay, so you can translate what is the value of this. Okay, so like the structure, what do you mean by structure? You can say, understand what I was telling you. You have to translate this XPR1, then you have to translate this term, then you have to add them together, right? So that is called handle the, you have to handle the class. Okay, so I think you have understood this, what I mean. It means these things will come in form of tree, right? Parser, that means the syntax analyzer will give you the syntax tree. And when you are just translating the value, that means at the root you have seen you had somewhere 9 plus 2, then some node is here. That node can give you a value 9 plus 2 equal to 11. Okay, so like that, something can come from this, and it can be generate say 2. Okay, now see, you have here something called something in some EXPR, and here you have multiplication. Okay, then you can again translate this EXPR like 11 multiplication 2 equal to 22. Understand? So this is what it means, and that is the thing we are going to do, called syntax directed translation. It means the syntax tree is giving you the syntax, you have gotten syntax tree, and you have translate the expression based on that. Okay, so an attribute is any quality associated with a programming construct. That means, say you have a variable name, okay, a variable name is a count. So what can be attribute of count? So any, what is it saying, is any quality of it. That means the data type, it can be its value, or it can be its memory address, and whatever, right? So all these things are called attribute of some programming construct. Example, data type of expression. So this is a kind of some expression can lead you to some variable name count. Okay, so type, there's a data type of the expression. The number of instruction in the generated code, or the location of the first instruction instruction in the generated code for a construct. Okay, among many other possibilities, there is many other possibilities which as I was telling you, which can be treated as attribute. Okay, so since we use grammar symbol, basically non-terminals and terminals we use to represent programming construct, we extend the notation of attributes from construct to the symbol of the symbols that represent them. So what happens when you write the program? So write say int a equal to 5. So what is this? All of these are basically the leaf node we are giving. Understand? All these are nothing but terminals we have written. Okay, so the non-terminals and the production rules are going to work in the background with the compiler. It is there. Okay, that we don't see. But if we write, if we do something like, int a equal to, then without giving any value, then the C compiler will throw an error. Why it will throw an error? When it will try to use try to construct the syntax tree, it will try to find out some value for this, okay, some terminal for this, but it will not find any terminal, okay. So it will generate an error for this part. Understand? Now, there is a syntax-directed translation schemes. The translation scheme is a notation for attaching program fragments to the procedure of grammar. So, sorry, to the production of a grammar. So, production rules we have seen, some simple production rules. Now, when you are doing, see, and you understand one thing. When you have generated this kind of parse tree, how to evaluate? Understand? 9 is a leaf here, plus is a leaf here, 2 is a leaf here. So how to evaluate the how this node will become 9 plus 2? So this rule is bit different from, so this is generated from, say, EXPR to say something term plus term. So this is just a production rule. This does not say how to do this addition, whether you have to do the addition or not. So that for doing that, you have to add some more data with this kind of production rules. Understand? When you have studied theory of computation, we have used only these production rules. There was no nothing associated with the production rule. We was understanding that a production rule will help us to drive a derivation tree, or here we have seen that some syntax tree we can generate. But again, generating the syntax tree is one part. After that, you have to translate. That means you have to evaluate the syntax tree, and you have to get the evaluated value at the root. So how to do the translation on the syntax tree? For doing the translation, you need, and again, some associated rules and regulation with each of this grammar production rule. Okay, so that is what we are speaking about here. The program fragments are executed when the production is used. The production is used during the syntax analysis. Okay, so the program fragments are executed when the production is used during the syntax analysis. That means, understand, when you write, I think I make it a bit clear. When you write this is what it will do. It will do two things. When you are going to construct this tree, it will help you to generate this kind of thing, EXPR to EXPR plus term. And on the other hand, it have to do, so when this is lead to 9, and so this is leading to 2, it have to do something, 9 plus 2 equal to 11. So how it will do this? For that, some program or some rules regulation means some program you have to write, and that program will be executed at the time of doing syntax analysis. Okay, and some of the rules will be also executed at the time of semantic analysis. Okay, so the combined result of these fragment executions, in order to induce by the syntax analysis. Okay, so it produces the translation of the program to which the analysis or synthesis process is applied. Okay, so I am showing you only this 9 plus 5 thing. So there will be many other synthesis, or you have other operation, like type conversion, type casting, array out of bound checking. So who will check? The compiler need to have some program fragments. Okay, with this kind of rules. Those program fragments will do that. Okay, and that helps you to do the translation. Next thing is postfix notation. This is what again we have come through in your data structure, right? So postfix notation is an expression E, and if it is a variable or constant, then the postfix notation for E is E itself. These are the rule. Now, if E is an expression, that means in infix notation, if you are writing E equal to E1, some operator given by this small circle, E2, where this is any binary operator, then the postfix notation will be written as E1, E2, then this operator. That means if you have something E1, some binary operator E2, if this is infix notation. In postfix, you can write E1, E2, and the operator. I think you can recall, you have already done it previously, right? So, where E1 and E2 are postfix notation for this. Okay. Now, if E is a parenthesized expression of the form E1 bracket, in bracket is only E1, then the postfix notation of E is same as, postfix notation for E1. Understand? So, this is what the basic things, how we write postfix notation. Okay. So the postfix notation for the same expression we have seen previously, how we can do it. So the translation of 9, 5 and 2 are constants themselves, right? So by rule 1, if you use rule 1, we take 9 minus 5 first, which will give 9, 5 and minus in first place, 9 and minus. And if we translate 9 minus 5 in the same rule with 3. I don't know the details. Okay, this is actually given the bracket, so the rule 3 was speaking about bracket, right? Yeah. So what is the rule 3? If something is given in the bracket, then the notation, the translation will be like this, simply the postfix notation gives you. Okay. Now, having the translated parenthesized expression, we may apply rule 2 again, on, because this part gives us 9 and 5 minus, right? So we can go forward, and assuming that this is in the bracket, I don't need the brackets. Okay, so we may apply rule 2 again to on the entire expression. That means this become one unit, and plus 2 is another part. Okay, now which gives us the rule E1 and E2 in the rule, and for the in the rule 2 we have seen. That will give us 1. So this already gives us 9, 5 minus, and the another part is 2. So 2 will come here, and this operator 2 plus will come at the end. So this is what it is going to be converted to. Okay. Now, what about if you. Okay, so for the previous one, we got this. Now, if I give. This one is your expression. Can you convert this to postfix notation? Write in the chat box the result immediately. It is a 1 minute task. Write in the chat box what will be the postfix notation for 9 minus 5 plus 2. Rishabh answered. Anybody else is having any other answer or any opinion on this? Okay, so see, As we know that this parenthesis is having the highest precedence, so we have to write the postfix notation for this first. So parenthesis 5 plus 2 will lead us to 5 2 and plus. Okay, so this became the output of this end. Okay, now if you put represent this by e only, okay, then we have basically 9 minus e. Okay, so this can give us in the postfix notation 9 e negative sign, right? Now if I put the value of e here, then it will give us 9 e is what? 5 2 plus, and we had the negative minus sign. Put the minus sign here. Okay, so I think it is clear to all how to convert to postfix notation. Okay, the same answer is given here. Evaluating postfix notation. So no parenthesis, good thing is here that we don't need the parenthesis anymore in postfix notation, because the postfix notation are arity, the number of arguments of the operators permits only one decoding of postfix expression at time. Okay, so because you can understand when if you see the previous postfix notation, we had done 9, 5, then 2, plus negative sign, right? So if you remember that how to evaluate this expression, we see that it is not giving you the ambiguity, the chance of choosing that whether you will apply plus first or minus first. Okay, that chance it is not giving you. So otherwise it will give you a unique result, if you are using postfix notation. Okay, so how to evaluate it? You repeatedly scan the postfix string from left. Okay, that means from left we start scanning it, okay, until you find an operator. Operator means this plus minus, all these things, right? Then look to the left for proper number of operands. Okay, then you search for proper number of operands evaluate the operator, definitely. And group this operator with its operands, definitely. Okay, now evaluate the operator on the operands and replace them by the result. Then repeat the process. Continue to your right and scanning the another operator, and keep doing the same thing, and you will get the final evaluated result. Okay, so something and some other expression is given. Before I go for this expression, I will ask you, who can step by step in the message box evaluate this expression using this set of rules given here. Rishabh Kumar, you have given the final answer. I asked you to do step by step using this these rules. You scan from left to right, until you get the first operator. Once you get the operator, you pick two operand and evaluate the operator, put the result, then again scan for another operator. If you get another operator, again you take the left and from here, the left side of the operator, you took two operand, evaluate them, and so on. You all of you are writing the final answer. I don't want final answer. I want step by step evaluation. Can anybody write it down? Yeah, Rishabh Kumar have posted, but for some other. Okay, so Rishabh have posted the answer for this expression. So what was the logic I have told you? I have told you, you start scanning from left to right until you meet with a operator. So I start scanning with from the left to right. First I get 9. Then I get 5, then I meet with 2, then I meet with the plus sign. So I got a plus sign. So when I get a, basically this operator, when I get operator, what I do, I immediately go back to the left and I pick two operands. So here the, two operands, we get 5 and 2 and apply the addition on them, okay? 5 and 2 I picked, and what operator I had got previously, the plus sign I will apply. So I get here 7. Okay. Then that means this expression became 9, 7, minus 3 in multiplication. Then again I scan from left to right. I meet with 9, 7, then the operator minus. So as soon as I get operator, I pick two operands from the left of the operator. That means here it is 9 and 7. 9 and 7. It gives 2 as answer. So now this expression became 2, 3 multiplication. So again I do start scanning from the left to right. I found 2, I found 3, then I found an operator. That operator is multiplication. So immediately I go to the left of the operator and pick two operands. Here these two operands and two operands are 2 and 3. So put 2 and 3 here, it gives you 6. So the final result becomes 6. Okay, so you can see the same thing is explained here. And final result is 6. I think it is clear to everybody. Okay. Then synthesized attributes. Okay, so there is a two kind of attributes which are very important. We'll meet again with those attributes in the further discussion, and they are. One is synthesized attribute and another is inherited attributes. So what is synthesized attribute? If some node is in this condition, 9 plus 5. So this node can evaluate its value as 9 plus 5 equal to 14. If it happens with some node, Then we will say that this node is having a synthesized attribute and which is whose value is 14. Okay, so if this node can calculate, the calculation is called synthesized actually. If it can calculate its attribute value by using its children's value or children's attribute, then we call it is a synthesized attribute. Okay, and by inherited attribute, you can understand if it is an inheriting form, parent or sibling, then it is going to be inherited attribute. Okay, now the idea of associating quantities with the programming constructs, for example, values and type with expression, can be expressed in term of grammar. So understand, you write what? Expression to something 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 goes to 9 plus and something, and here it comes to digit, then I say something 5 coming. Okay, but that is not everything here. We want to evaluate what can be the value, e dot value. That means what can be the evaluated value at node E, where E is there. Okay, so that logic also we want, and we can get here as a 9 plus 14, whatever. Okay, so this thing is one thing, that is what expression can be expressed in term of grammar. Okay, then we associate attribute with non-terminal and terminals. So this kind of attribute, like the value and other attributes, can be associated with there's the here it is non-terminal, you can see here this is a terminal. So with each of them, this kind of things can be associated. So if it is 9, so what can be the attribute from 9? The attribute can be the data type. So it is integer. Okay, so 9 also can have some data type, some attribute which is data type and which is integer. Okay, then we attach a rule to the production of the grammar. What kind of rule? This rule describes how the attributes are computed. That means we have added attribute val to E. Now we have to also tell some rule we have to add with this, that how this value of the this val will be calculated. Okay, so that we need to add. Okay, at those nodes of the parse tree where the production in question is used to relate a node to be its children. Okay, then synthesized attributes, the syntax directed definition associates with this with each grammar symbol a set of attributes, and with each production a set of semantic rules for computing the values of the attributes associated with the symbols appearing in the production. So these semantic rules for computing the values of attributes associated with the symbols appearing in the production. These semantic rules are known as these semantic rules are going to be associated with the production rule. Understand? With the production rule. Now, attributes can be evaluated as follows. For a given input string X, construct a parse tree for X, then apply semantic rules, evaluate the attribute at each of the node in the parse tree. So that is what I am telling. Okay. So suppose a node N in the parse tree is leveled by the grammar is symbol X. Okay, so you have a node which is labeled as X, and you have an attribute for X that is A. Okay, to denote value of the attribute A of X at the node, we use this notation X dot A. Okay, so a parse tree showing the attribute values At each node is called annotated parse tree. So what is annotated parse tree? If in a parse tree, if you evaluate this kind of values, and if you write them and if you display them on the tree itself, then that tree will be called as annotated parse tree. So can you draw an annotated parse tree for this expression? So annotated parse tree for this with an attribute T associated with non-terminal, ESPR and tra. So we had that grammar with ESPR and term. So use that grammar to first generate the syntax tree, and then you evaluate the values on each node and foot, and you will get the result what it want. You will get the result means you will get the annotated parse tree. So if I start, the rule, first rule we had that is EXPR. If I apply the this one first, EXPR minus tab. Okay, then this EXPR can give us EXPR plus tar. Then this EXPR can give us only term. Now a term can give you a factor. Okay, then this factor can give you digit and digit, and this digit you can put every time I am starting it here I should use this rule with plus, and here I will put the first rule with a negative sign. Okay, then this digit can give us 9, this digit can give us 5, and this digit can give us 2. Understand? Now this is syntax tree. Now I want to convert this to annotated parse tree, or you can say this is parse tree. I want to convert this to annotated parse tree. So I put digit dot val. That means I am adding attribute to digit val. Val is the attribute which is representing the value of this digit. So I can write dot val equal to 9. Factor, again with factor I am adding another, so the val equal to 9. Term dot val equal to 9. XPR dot val equal to 9. Here also I add them equal to 5, factor dot val equal to 5. Here you can see these are basically synthesized attributes, because this value of val at this node is basically calculated from the previous node, but from the child node. Okay. Equal to 5. 2 factor dot val here equal to 2. Okay. Now here expr dot val. What we will have? We have 9 minus 5. So that rule should be associated here with this, that that will look like this. Later we will see. EXPR dot val is EXPR dot val minus term
dot
Now we know expr dot val is 9 and term dot val we have 5. So 9 minus 5. So expr dot val, this value is going to be 4. Understand? So finally here also term dot val will have, which will be 2, and expr dot val can be created as 4 plus 2 equal to 6. Okay, so this is how it happens. So here you can see this what I have seen, I have done there. It is done in different way. They have not totally evaluated to the value. Instead, they put it the expression, because they have used t associated with non-terminal expression and tar. Okay, and they are keeping it like this. Here at this point, if you see in postfix notation, 9, 5, and then coming the operator. Okay, then it is 2. Here I had basically calculated the value of 9 minus 5. They have kept it as it is, no issue. Okay, then at the top here they are doing, they are adding this plus and 2 at the end, and it is giving this expression. Okay, so this is also, this can also be called as untreated parse tree. Okay, so this lecture basically.